name's Adi Gundlapalli. I'm an infectious disease physician and informatics specialist. I'm at the Salt Lake City VA. I'm the chief health informatics officer for the VA Salt Lake City healthcare system and a staff physician there. Our veterans face many challenges as they transition from military service to civilian life. And several of those challenges include economic instability, social support or lack of, mental health disorders, alcohol substance abuse. And so our goal has been to try and improve our understanding of that subset of veterans who face housing challenges. The way we're approaching it is looking at structured data, which consists of administrative data such as ICD-9 codes, visits to different VA healthcare centers, and also looking at unstructured data, which is free text medical notes. So we're looking at the free text medical notes and teaching the computer to look for clues or evidence for early homelessness in those notes. The goal there is to try and see if we can mitigate and prevent and intervene before they become homeless. The time of separation from the military, their active duty service members are given a separation category. So unfortunately, there is a category called misconduct for which our service members have gotten into some sort of challenges during service. Only less than 6% of them are discharged or separated from the military for misconduct. However, when we looked at homelessness rates in those veterans, at 30 days, 1 year and 5 years after separation or coming to the VA, we found that nearly a quarter of all homeless veterans were from the misconduct category. That to date is probably one of the most significant predictors of homeless. The idea there would be while they transition, then maybe the VA and the Department of Defense, we can use existing programs. The VA has tremendous amount of existing programs for case management and helping veterans who are facing housing challenges. So if we do more of a warm handoff and an active case management of this subset of the vulnerable, then maybe we can mitigate and intervene on their front. As a staff physician, I have the honor and privilege of treating veterans when they're in the hospital. And as we're doing our rounds and looking at it, always in the back of, is in the back of my mind in terms of their risk for homelessness and their challenges they're facing. And so we try to bring that perspective in saying, oh, if you're going to send this patient home with this medication or this particular treatment option or home health, well, do they have a home? Do they have social support? Can somebody change their bandages? Can they help them with the IV antibiotics, et cetera? So I think it does help bring that perspective down to the individual veteran level. And similarly, when we're talking to others on rounds or hearing from our house staff or students or colleagues and say, oh, there's this challenge we're facing and we don't understand why this is going on, it's nice to bring that back to the researcher's table and say, you know, there's a high priority question and maybe we can, offer them some answers or at least hypothesis generating so we can look at how to improve the care and quality of life for our veterans. If we're able to look at and help even an individual veteran, I think it's very humbling to see the challenges they've gone through, thank them for their service. In VA hospitals, we see all periods of service represented, the elderly, the World War I and subsequent Vietnam era veterans. And nowadays we're seeing both in the outpatient and inpatient clinic, the younger OEF, OIF and Operation New Dawn veterans also coming in. So I think it does make a difference. We have to know every day when we walk into the medical center or in the clinic why we're here and work towards that common goal of improving the healthcare and the quality of life for our veterans.